where are you going? What's your target? What are you doing? And I think that's very important for all entrepreneurs to have when they get going. Hello and welcome to the Top Line Entrepreneur Podcast. We are back. We are back at it. We were actually putting together a good podcast for you last week, and I didn't execute something that I needed to get it out to you, but that will be coming out too. So you'll have a few different shows to binge watch or binge listen to if you listen to us on iTunes or Spotify. But again, welcome to the Top Line Entrepreneur. Today's show is all about the 10 things you need to know before you start a business. If you guys don't know me, my name is Brett Summers. I'm a strength and conditioning coach at Top Line Gym, and I'm the founder and owner of that gym as well, which I started 11 years ago. This October was the 11 year, the beginning of the 11th year. So it was a 10 year anniversary. 10 years are complete. We completed the full circle. And that is why I feel like I'm obligated to help you guys out on your entrepreneurial journey. No matter if you're maybe a hairdresser or a hairstylist, or maybe you're starting a clothing line, or maybe you're starting a little bit bigger business, a marketing or promotional company, or real estate, or who knows what you want to do. Maybe you want to start out a law firm, or maybe you want to start off and you want to be a sports agent, super agent, like Ari Gold was a movie agent in Entourage, or maybe you want to be like The Rock in Ballers and you want to work with all sorts of different athletes. We're going to help you out with that today. And these are 10 serious questions that all entrepreneurs or potential entrepreneurs should ask themselves before you guys take the leap. So here, buckle up. We're going to keep this short and sweet today. Again, thank you guys for tuning in, but I want to dive right into it. The first thing that you need to know before you start a business is, are you a leader? Now, that's an important question because a lot of times people start their entrepreneurial journey just by themselves, which is okay. But at a certain point in your entrepreneurial journey, you are going to have to hire people. You are going to have to include other people around you, and you won't be able to just be a hermit who sits, you know, a recluse like Howard Hughes, where you lock yourself into a hotel room and you don't see or talk to anybody. No matter how many times you've read The 4-Hour Work Week, which is a book that I read a couple times, and I totally dislike, because there is no such thing as the 4-Hour Work Week. So I know you guys that are getting sold on that book, and that's probably why that book did so good, is because people thought that they could be by themselves, they could be in isolation, they could only work a few hours a week and still somehow effectively lead an entire company that was generating millions of dollars. So Tim Ferriss, unfortunately, I like Tools of Titans. That was a good book, but the other book, not so good for entrepreneurs. But are you a leader? Can you develop relationship with people? Can you get people to follow you? Can you get people to buy into your mission of the business, whatever it is you want to accomplish? Can you do that? That's an important question to ask. It's an important thing to know. Do you have some of those leadership qualities that just draw people to you, that people, that they believe you, they believe in you, they want to be like you, they want to be around you? I'm not saying every entrepreneur has that, but to a certain extent, even if it's just their ideas, people want to be a part of it. So make sure you ask yourself that question. Number two on the list is, are you resourceful? Every entrepreneur has to be extremely resourceful. You have to know what you need, even though you don't have it currently. You have to be able to find a way to go get it. Again, entrepreneurs are problem solvers. We're people that come up with, we think differently. We're always trying to come up with a new way to solve a problem. We're trying to come up with a new way to fix something that's broken. Or even if it's not broken, we're trying to improve on that. So as an entrepreneur, you need to ask yourself, do I have what it takes to figure out how to go start a website, how to go launch the website, how to start filming videos and getting them uploaded to YouTube? Me and Britt went through that process when we started to put these podcasts online. So all you guys that are out there listening to the podcast and you're thinking, man, these guys are doing so much. Well, hey, we started just like you guys. We had no clue. We were like, let's do it. Let's mic up. Let's get the videos going. Let's start it up. and figure out how we can get it done. Remember that? We didn't know how to get on iTunes. Were we on iTunes?
Nothing.
Were we on Stitcher? We didn't know if we're on that kind of stuff. But you got to get started. You've got to find answers. And if you don't know the answer, you have to be able to find people who know the answers to your problems. That's number two. Number three, can you handle getting punched in the face 1,000 times in a row and keep going? That's what entrepreneurship is, especially in the beginning. So you've got to ask yourself when you wake up in the morning, even when you're 10 or 11 years in like me, do you want to get punched in the face? I've had some things in the last, just this last week, problems that shouldn't, they shouldn't be problems. Unfortunately, as much as I want to assume control for it, I had to deal with it and I had to get socked in the face. That's just part of business. That's the cost of doing business. In fact, I was meeting with a mentor of mine late last night. He says, hey, when you're in business, the higher you get up, the more problems you're going to have to face, the more people that are going to cause problems for you are going to come up in your life. It's kind of like Biggie Smalls used to say, more money, more problems, right? So be prepared for that. Be prepared to get kicked and punched in the face because that is a part of the entrepreneurial game. Number four, can you talk to people without talking about yourself, without talking about your problems and about what's so bad about your life and about what this person did to you and about what you want and about what your business's mission is? Remember, if you're in business, you're in business to solve a problem. If you're in business to solve a problem, that means you got to be able to know what's going on in Britt's life and what's going on in Blake's life and what's going on in all of your clients, Renee and Dizzard and Bomber and all the rest of you guys. That you guys don't care about what's going on in my life. You guys care that I care what's going on in your life. So you have to know that being an entrepreneur is going to mean that your feelings and your emotions, unfortunately, are going to have to be repressed a little bit because you need to focus on how you can solve other people's problems. And that is a part of the game. There is no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's part of the entrepreneurial game. So make sure you guys are prepared for that. And number five, wow, we already touched on this. Do you know how to solve problems? And when we're talking about that, that's more than just being resourceful. Solving problems is what you're going to have when you have an angry customer or when you've not maybe satisfied a customer. Maybe there's just a slight hiccup. That's not the end of the world as an entrepreneur. Actually, it's a really good opportunity for you to swoop in, for you to show the client that you have the integrity and character of a really good business and that you guys are willing to fix the problem, whatever it may be, and you're willing to find a solution. Okay? If you have a problem in the distribution of your social media content, if you're thinking one thing and someone else is thinking one thing, you just simply come up with a solution. It's not a big blow up. It's not a big problem. It's just a matter of saying, here's what's working. Here's what's not working. Let's make an adjustment. Let's solve our problem. Let's be able to get more views. Let's be able to get more people to see what we need to see. Do we need new equipment? Do we have to order another terabyte? Do we have to buy another computer? What do we have to do to solve the problem? Britt's laughing right now because those are some things that we faced here at Topline, and it's not the end of the world. It's just something that has to be solved, okay? Number six, do you know how to ask for the sale? So important. Unfortunately, I don't know what the statistic is. I believe my uncle GC sometimes references it and says that about 92% of the time, salespeople don't even ask for the sale. I've seen that in real estate. I've seen that in selling real estate. I've seen that in leasing real estate. I've seen that in top line even. You know, did we offer them coming out the door? We've had that here and it's like, you know, a guest comes in. Did you make them an offer? All you got to do is simply say, hey, what'd you think? Oh, we loved it. Oh, you loved it? Cool. Well, would you guys be interested in, bang, make an offer? Or at the end, maybe they do a challenge like they do here at Topline. At the end of the challenge, it's our job to ask you and say, hey, have you guys seen enough to make a decision on making a commitment to join Topline? It's simple, but a lot of entrepreneurs just don't know how to get to that point, or maybe they don't have the confidence, or maybe they don't have the belief in their business, or maybe they're just starting off as an entrepreneur, which I'm assuming that many of you are. If you're really doing it big, I wouldn't assume that you're actually taking the time to watch this show or listen to it. But if you're just starting off, maybe you don't have a lot of money, so you're feeling the pressure of that. So because you're feeling so pressured, and it's such a big deal to you, you're hesitant to ask because of fear of rejection or failure. Something you have to get over as an entrepreneur. You've got to ask for the sale. Every time more than one time. That's just the name of the game in business, okay? Your business livelihood depends on that. Number seven, would you rather invest money into cars, vacations, clothes, belts, jewelry, movie tickets, wheels, whatever it is? Would you rather invest in that, or would you rather invest in books, in seminars, in mentorship, and back into your business, into marketing and promotion? If your goal of starting your business is to acquire possessions, is to have the time freedom that everyone's looking after, that's what they want when they start a business. They think that being an entrepreneur automatically means that you've got 20 minions running around and they're doing all the work for you and you don't have to lead. It's not like that at all. So you have to know if you're getting into business for the right reasons or not. If you want to get into business just to ball out and to wake up whenever you want and to walk around in your underpants for about 3 hours in the morning, I don't know if being an entrepreneur is the right thing for you. So you want to know that before you get into it. Why do I want to start the business? Is it to grow it and scale it, or is it to just buy things for myself? And number eight, would you rather work in the business or would you rather work on the business? Now, someone like myself, I love business and I love it because it's just like a sport. There are certain things that you do in business that give you good results. There's certain systems you have to put in place, like the New England Patriots or some of these celebrity, the best teams and some of the best celebrities. You have to have systems in place to be able to get to where you want to go and be able to run a big infrastructure. So I love the business side of things. But what that means is I can't be in the gym like I was when I first started coaching at 6, 9 a.m. And then in the afternoon I'm coaching again. And then I'm coaching again from 3 o'clock till 10 o'clock at night. Because that's called working in the business. I'm delivering the service. That's called being self-employed, and that is a job. I don't really view that as entrepreneurship. While you have to be entrepreneurial, you're also working in the business, delivering the services, taking out the trash, answering the phone calls, answering the emails, setting up the Shopify account, setting up the merchant accounts, checking the bank statements. That means you're doing everything. That's what I'm trying to get away from, and that's what we're trying to get away from at Topline. We got Britt and Blake. They started up the morning training sessions, which is a huge help, been a good boon to business. I think it will be moving forward because I'm not the bottleneck holding it back anymore. We have people in here who can help expand it and grow it, and they're competent, and I trust them. And they're great team members, they're A players, they're people that want to get it done. And speaking of that, we are going to be hiring again soon because, as Britt will tell you, we've got a lot of stuff going on. We've got a lot of things going in the fire right now. So we need some extra help. So if you're a motivated, high energy, you've got big goals and you want to achieve big things and be a part of something big, we are hiring. So I highly suggest that you guys send us a 60 to 90 second video. You can do that on Instagram or YouTube or LinkedIn or create a website. Whatever you got to do, be creative, be an A player, do what A players do. Don't shoot some crappy video on your iPhone that doesn't tell the proper story, that only talks about you. No one wants to watch it. Going in to number nine. Okay, that was just a little plug for what we're doing here. What will you do with the revenue after you make it? Now, I'm not talking, again, what are you going to invest the money into, the money that you make. I'm talking about what are you going to do with the revenue for your business? Going to scale it? You going to grow to another location? Are you going to take that money and maybe take that money and put it into a different business? Are you going to maybe be like McDonald's and purchase the real estate that your business operates out of and then lease it back to yourself, lease it back to your other business? Are you going to do some things like that, which a lot of car dealerships do and things like that? Or are you going to think a little bit bigger? That's what I'm trying to get you to think about. When you start your little business, whatever it is, your print shop, your shoe company, whatever you're trying to do, think about what you're going to do with the money after you make it, because you can't just go spend that on all sorts of liabilities. You need to reinvest it back into your business for growth and for scale and into your staff and into your team and into marketing and into promotions and all sorts of different things and assets to make sure you can decrease your tax liability and not get whacked by the IRS at the end of the year. So what are you going to do with the money? Something important to know before you go on. And number 10, quite possibly the most important of all the things you need to know before you start your business. And while I don't suggest you be hesitant and sit and lollygag around and not take action and start your business, you have to know what the mission and the purpose and the vision for the whole business is going to be before you start. And I'm not saying that won't change, but you have to have some sort of target when you start, because if you don't have a target, you're going to just be waking up every day and you're just going to start doing this and start doing that, and you're not going to go down a straight path. You're going to go zigzagging right, and you're going to zigzag left, and you're going to veer around, you're going to circle back, and you're going to do a U-turn, and you're going to do a 360, and by the end of it, you won't even know where the hell you're at. So you need to make sure that you have a clear vision, a clear mission, and a clear purpose for your business. I read that one, and I got dialed into that back in 2013 through Bedros Koulian, and he was an early mentor for me in the fitness business. He helped me out substantially to be able to scale and grow my business. And that's one of the things that he preached about, is where are you going? What's your target? What are you doing? And I think that's very important for all entrepreneurs to have when they get going. Now, those are your 10 things. You guys got them, okay? Ask yourself those questions. Sit down, grab a piece of paper. I do this every morning, but I'm a little bit more concrete because I know where I'm going. But these are good questions to ask yourself in the morning when you wake up as an entrepreneur, because then you know that those answers to those questions will dictate what you do the rest of the day. So I appreciate all you guys joining us here on the Top Line Entrepreneur. I thought it was a very valuable show, and if I was watching this 11 years ago, I would have pulled a lot of value from it. So if you're not an entrepreneur, those might be some questions you can ask yourself about your family. You can do that. Am I doing what I need to do with my family? Am I doing what I need to do to get my faith to where it wants to be? And am I doing what I need to do to get my fitness to where it needs to be? But this is what we think about here at Top Line. Yeah, we push this Top Line Entrepreneur out on Top Line Gym's social media and some of the other things we're doing, and then some of my personal social media. That's what we stand for. These are the things that we stand for. These are the things we're thinking about. So if you're a potential customer out there and you're watching this, this is just who we are. We're thinking, we're trying to grow, we're trying to expand, we're trying to service you guys really well, and we're excited to meet you. And for anybody who just listened or watched it, thank you for your time. Subscribe to the channel, and if you could just share this video with one person who you think it might help. If you could share it with one or two people, whoever they are, maybe they're young entrepreneurs, or maybe that they're a son or daughter or family member who has some entrepreneurial traits and you wanna push them into that because you think it would be a good fit for them. Share this with them. We appreciate you guys watching it, and I hope you guys have an awesome, awesome rest of the week.